Hello, my name is Okuaki Toshiomi. I belong to the International Department of Oomoto and the Director of Esperanto Popularization Association, which is a satellite organization of Oomoto to promote international language Esperanto. Today, I will introduce the third spiritual leader of Oomoto, Madame Deguchi Naohi. Here is a photo of Naohi. She was born on the 7th of March in 1902 in Ayabe. She is the eldest daughter of Deguchi Onisaburo and Sumiko. Here is a family tree for Deguchi family. Nao, the foundress of Oomoto, is the grandmother for Naohi. The parents of Naohi is Onisaburo and Sumiko. Onisaburo is the co-founder of Oomoto, and Sumiko is the second spiritual leader. The husband of Naohi is Hidemaru, and Kiyoko, the fourth leader of Oomoto, is daughter of Naohi, and Kurenai, the current leader, is the granddaughter of Naohi. From the early time, the succession of position of spiritual leader by Naohi had been decided. Nao predicted the birth of the girl, Naohi, and the succession of the position of spiritual leader by Naohi. To say more concretely, Nao received revelation as such in 1910. The labor of the second spiritual leader after Nao Deguchi fulfills Sumi, the youngest daughter of Nao, and the labor of the third inherits Naohi, the first daughter of Sumi. This is the decision of God. Naohi was born in 1902, so when she was 8 years old, the succession of the spiritual leader by Naohi was already decided clearly by God, who possessed the foundress Nao. After the graduation from the elementary school, Naohi learned at junior high school, but she gave up. She began to live in Kyoto City in 1915, when she was 15 years old, and enthusiastically practiced Japanese swordsmanship, Kendo. In 1918, Naohi had been asked by the grandmother Nao to return to Ayabe. Naohi respected the grandmother Nao and helped Oomoto affairs. But after 7 months from her return to Ayabe, Nao passed away. From then, the co-founder Onisaburo led Oomoto. Naohi was 16 years old at that time. And next year, Naohi began to learn tea ceremony, one of Japanese traditional arts. In 1921, the great tragedy attacked Oomoto. The first Oomoto incident occurred. Oomoto was oppressed by the then Japanese government because of Lee's majesty and so on. And the main shrine just completed in Ayabe was destroyed. At that time, in Japan, the freedom of religion is not sufficiently guaranteed. Her father, Onisaburo, was arrested. At that time, Naohi was 19 years old. The first Oomoto incident was solved because of the amnesty after the passing of Taisho Tenno in 1927. Regardless of difficulty of the first incident, Naohi began to learn calligraphy and the playing two-string koto for worship service at Oomoto. Moreover, when she was 20s, she began to learn no play and joined the circle of tanka poetry. By the way, she loved the oldest tanka collection in Japan, Manyoshu, collection of 10,000 leaves. In 1928, Naohi married Hidemaru, when she was 26 years old. Hidemaru was 30 years old. Hidemaru was born on the 28th of December in 1897 in Kurashiki City of Okayama Prefecture. His original name is Takami Motoo. Takami is family name. Hidemaru began to work at Omoto Center before graduation in Kyoto University. He learned in the Faculty of Literature. Now he became to know Hidemaru through her sister, and Hidemaru taught Japanese literature and history of Orient to Naohi. Later, between them, one son and three daughters were born. Naohi and Hidemaru supported the co-founder of Omoto, Onisaburo, who was the father of Naohi. Thanks to Onisaburo and activity of Hidemaru, Omoto progressed, but in 1935, tragedy attacked Omoto again. The second incident happened. Japanese government oppressed Omoto again for His Majesty to Tenno and so on. Then, oppression was cruel, in fact. All constructions at Omoto was destroyed. Then, Onisaburo and Sumiko were arrested. Naohi was not arrested, but her husband Hidemaru was arrested and severely tortured in prison because he was regarded as the successor of Onisaburo. Hidemaru accomplished longevity, but never completely recovered. The second Omoto incident was settled in 1945 after the defeat of Japan in World War II. 3 years later from the settlement of the second incident, the co-founder of Omoto, Onisaburo, passed away, and Sumiko led Omoto as the second spiritual leader. But 4 years later, Sumiko also passed away. Now he became the third spiritual leader according to passing away of Sumiko in 1952. Now he was 50 years old. Her period continued from 1952 to the time of her passing away in 1990. So during 38 years. This is the longest period as spiritual leader. According to Onisaburo, goddess Konohana Sakuyahime possesses or protects Naohi. The goddess appears in Japanese myth, Kojiki, and Nihon Shoki. People say the goddess is a guardian god of the Mount Fuji, the highest and most sacred mountain in Japan, and also devotes herself to cultural affairs. On the other hand, according to the teaching of Omoto, god Hikohoho Demi possesses or protects Hidemaru. The god Hikohoho Demi also appears in the Japanese myth. Hidemaru supported the labor of Naohi spiritually during her period. We name Hidemaru alternate leader. Omoto names the role of Naohi and Hidemaru Hinode no Kami. Hinode means sunrise. Kami is God. So Hinode no Kami means sunrise God. In fact, the activity of Omoto drastically progressed as sunrise under the leadership of Naohi and Hidemaru. So what Naohi did during her time from 1952 to 1990? First, change of name to Omoto. On the 31st of March in 1952, Sumiko passed away and Naohi became the third spiritual leader. That the name of religious organization would change to Omoto on the 1st of April had been arranged in advance. In earlier history of Omoto, the name as organization often changed. So accidentally, at the same time with the first day of Naohi as the third spiritual leader, the name of the organization changed to Omoto. Since then, the name of our religious organization has never changed. In 1953, Naohi discovered a new species of cherry tree. She didn't have a profound knowledge of botany. She discovered it in the sanctuary of Omoto in Kameoka. And the cherry tree was named Konohana by chance. As I mentioned, the name of the goddess who possesses Naohi is Konohana Sakuya Hime or Konohana Hime. So people say that is a kind of miracle. Certain botanists gave the name of the Konohana to it. Naohi loves the cherry tree very much. She even planted the Konohana by her house. The flower of the cherry tree has more petals than other cherry trees. It became a symbol tree in Omoto. Not only in sanctuaries of Omoto, but also in the chapters of Omoto, it has been planted. The motto of Naohi was Faith is Life and Art. She had practiced several Japanese traditional arts by herself during her leadership and encouraged Omoto followers to learn them. For example, tea ceremony, chanting and dancing of no performance, calligraphy, martial arts, ceramic art, and so on. And such atmosphere is lasting even now. So I also learned chanting and dancing of no performance and playing of Japanese drum for no. On the basis of motto, Faith is Life and Art, Naohi designed the prayer house Banshoden. Ban means 10,000. Sho is happiness. Den is building. So Banshoden means the prayer house of 10,000 happiness. It is the main shrine in sanctuary of Omoto in Kameoka. It was completed in 1958. Naohi was 56 years old at that time. At the prayer house, Omoto followers pray in the morning and evening every day. In addition to that, monthly services and summer grand festival are held here. There is a no theater in the prayer house, and a tea house accompanies the building. According to Naohi, the prayer house symbolizes faith. Tea house symbolizes life. No theater symbolizes art. So this building embodies her motto, Faith is Life and Art. Naohi performed no by herself on the occasion of the inauguration ceremony for the building. She played a leading role at that time. Naohi was very enthusiastic about conservation of Japanese traditions. She moved traditional farmer's house to the sanctuary of Omoto in Ayabe. It is now registered as one of important cultural assets in Japan. And under the initiatives of Naohi, many tea houses were constructed in sanctuaries of Omoto, and the house for spiritual leader was completed in Ayabe. These buildings were constructed on the basis of Japanese traditional construction manner. Naohi made special base in Asuka village when she was 65 years old. Where is Asuka village? Here is a map of Japan. Kyoto prefecture has black circle. Here is Omoto centers. And Nara prefecture has red circle. Here is a map of Nara prefecture. There is Asuka village. Asuka was the capital of Japan from the end of the 6th century to the beginning of the 8th century. People say that it is hometown for Japanese hearts. When Naohi set up special base of Omoto in Asuka, the economy of Japan drastically progressed. In Asuka village, fields were destroyed and modern houses were constructed, one after another. Naohi felt danger against the movement and wanted to conserve the village as Japanese cultural essence. Her hope reached to the then prime minister by certain Omoto follower. As a result, the law to conserve Asuka village was approved in the Parliament of Japan, so her hope came true. Naohi was outstanding artist. She was a calligrapher, painter, and ceramic artist, and actress in no performance. So she made many arts, and she even played no at no theater for professional no performer. Through such art activities, Naohi had many friendships with eminent intellectuals. From upper left, Mr. Shimizu Hian, he is a poet, calligrapher, politician. And upper right, Mr. Tachibana Daiki, he is a Buddhism monk in Daitokuji Temple in Kyoto of Rinzai Buddhism School. Now he sometimes held joint exhibitions of arts with them. And below left, Mr. Kawabata Yasunari, he is a novelist, who is the first Japanese winner of Nobel Prize in Literature Department. And below right, Ms. Shirasu Masako, she is essayist. And Mr. Ishiguro Munemaro, he is a ceramic artist, and Setouchi Jakucho, she is a Buddhism monk and novelist. Mr. Matsumoto Seicho, he is a detective novelist. And Okabe Itsuko, she is essayist. And Shimura Fukumi, she is dyer. And from foreign country, Professor Vadim Eliseev, the director of Selenovsky Museum in Paris, he visited Naohi in 1971. And he wanted to bring back the artist atmosphere of Omoto to Paris. That came true as an exhibition of arts about Omoto in his museum. In 1972, the exhibition of arts of Omoto began in Selenovsky Museum. Now he was 70 years old at that time. Here's some photos. And the list of art exhibitions of Omoto in Europe. 5 places in France, 1 in UK, Netherlands, and Belgium. Now he never went to trip to foreign countries, but she prayed for success of exhibition from Japan. In 1975, an American doctor, Frederick Frank, visited Omoto. He watched arts of Omoto in United Kingdom and very moved. He recommended the holding of exhibitions to his friend in USA. He later wrote even book about Omoto titled Encounter with Omoto. That's why Omoto exhibitions in the North America came true. Here is a list. 4 places in USA and 1 in Canada. Exhibitions of arts of Omoto in foreign countries were held totally in 13 places of 6 countries during 3 years and 3 months. On the occasion of the exhibition in the Cathedral of St. John the Divine in New York, Omoto-style service also was held in the cathedral. It is notable that Shinto ceremony was held in the Cathedral of Christianity. The Cathedral of St. John the Divine belongs to Anglican Church, one of Protestants. Next year, Dean James Sparks Morton, the chief of St. John the Divine, visited Omoto Center and greeted to Naohi. In 1977, the first common ritual between Omoto and Anglicanism in Ayabe was held. I think such a trial is the first in the world history. Before the altar of Shinto, joint worship service between Omoto and Anglicanism was held at that time. Omoto followers even sang hymns of Christianity. Yuasa Hachiro, the professor emeritus of International Christian University, participated in the joint ceremony. After the joint worship service, the professor Yuasa gave a greeting. In it, he created the word interreligionization. This is how Omoto developed interreligious activities positively, under the leadership of Naohi. Later, the exchange between Omoto and Anglican Church in USA more and more deepened. At one time, a scholar about Japanese studies and honorary professor of Columbia University, Donald Keene, explained the meaning of no performance played by Omoto followers at the Cathedral of St. John the Divine like that. In no, usually professionals act, but on the occasion of the no in Omoto, amateur Omoto followers act. In Omoto, acting in no is like prayer training. Omoto followers consider the no as a way to approach divinity. This idea is an original goal when No was born. I think that the meaning of artistic activity at Omoto is just expressed in his saying. The later, fourth spiritual leader performed No in Canterbury Cathedral in UK. This cathedral also belongs to Anglican Church. It is headquarters of Anglican Church. And he is the chief of Canterbury Cathedral. He visited Omoto in 1980. To mention about the relationship with Catholicism. Catholicism was not enthusiastic about interreligious movement. But after Second Vatican Council, held from 1962 to 65, Catholicism began to open the door to another religions. The Cardinal of Catholicism visited Omoto in 1976, and next year Omoto followers offered the prayer in the altar of St. Peter Cathedral in Vatican and held Omoto-style worship service in the Palace of Catholicism. Here is the audience with the Pope, Paul VI. The Pope John Paul II summoned world religious leaders to prayer in Assisi in Italy in 1986. Yamada Etai, the head priest of the Tendai Japanese traditional Buddhism sect, participated in the prayer gathering in Assisi, and he planned to hold the prayer gathering at his headquarters on the Mount Hiei in Japan. He by himself visited Naohi to ask cooperation, because he knew that the Omoto developed interreligious activity enthusiastically. The head priest Yamada is on the far left. And in 1987, the first religious summit on Mount Hiei was held under the help and cooperation of Omoto. In addition, in 1978, royal family of the dynasty Pahlavi of Iran visited Omoto and Naohi. In 1980, Dalai Lama the 14th visited Omoto Center during his staying in Japan. So in such a way, Omoto became familiar in the world scale. In 1975, American scientist about Orient culture, Mr. David Kidd, who had lived in Kyoto from 1970s, visited Naohi at Omoto Center, and he asked the establishment of the Omoto School about traditional Japanese arts. Naohi accepted his ask, and she became honorary chief of the school when she was 74 years old, and David Kidd became the chief of the school. At this school, foreigners learned many Japanese traditional arts and teachings of Omoto in summer during 1 month, mainly at Omoto Center. The professionals taught each arts. After the exhibitions in foreign countries, the Omoto School of Traditional Japanese Arts has begun. To 1995, totally 18 times it was held. Foreigners from Netherlands, UK, France, USA, Brazil, India, Iran, Tibet, and so on participated in it. Now, some succeeded as artists and others as scientists. The most popular participant in the Omoto School is Mr. Lyell Watson. He was a botanist, zoologist, and anthropologist. Under the leading of Naohi, Omoto marked successful culmination in its history after World War II. The name of Omoto became famous as a sunrise. So here is another theme. I introduced the writings of Naohi. Naohi was also essayist. Several her essay books were published by Japanese, and her collections of poems were also published by Japanese. Photo album about ceramics made by her was redacted. On the other hand, about Hidemaru, he was a thinker, and some books were published by Japanese. From then, people can read one book written in Hidemaru in English. The title is In Search of Meaning. This book will certainly give you bravery and self-confidence for life. You will be able to get it through International Department of Omoto, and you can also read his book The Creation of Meaning in English by Internet. And I will present about Esperanto and Naohi. The year 1963 was the 40 years anniversary of the founding of Esperanto Popularization Association, the satellite organization of Omoto about Esperanto. To commemorate it, the monument Unu Dio, Unu Mondo, Unu Interlingvo, One God, One World, One Intermediate Language by English, which is the motto of Omoto, was built. Naohi had learned Esperanto by herself. The year 1965, Omoto International Festival was held at Omoto as a post-Congress event of the 15th Universal Congress of Esperanto, which was held in Tokyo. It was the first Universal Congress in Asia. At that time, she, as the third spiritual leader, greeted to the participants by Esperanto. And here is the idea about Esperanto of Naohi from her writings. To achieve world peace, all nations must be placed in an equal position. The first element of its basis is an international common language. This common language must be used as the second national language. As for Esperanto, I think that learning it is more important than its movement, and it is absolutely necessary to become a resident in the future peaceful world. Esperanto is what will unite the world over the barriers of politics, religion, and race, and what is always on a position common to both sides, right and left. So, Esperanto is nothing but one that acts so peacefully and impartially on peace. And Esperanto and Hidemaru. In fact, Hidemaru is said to be the earliest learner of Esperanto in Oomoto. When he was in high school, he learned about the existence of Esperanto. In May 1923, before marrying Naohi, he handed over the article for an Esperanto course to Onisaburo. Onisaburo ordered his secretary to take part in the course. About a month after that, the current Esperanto Popularization Association was established in Oomoto. Later, he himself even taught Esperanto. So Hidemaru played a very important role when Oomoto introduced Esperanto. And I will introduce the idea of Hidemaru about Esperanto from his writings. The contemporary thinker circle, pouring day after day into chaos, the hearts of the public almost not to be saved, and from then the resulting daily events miserable and contradictory. So, where do all these come from? That comes from the heart divided into small individuals, a heart that cannot love humanity and even foreigners. In other words, this stems from the fact that more than 40 states use approximately 1,200 different languages. What can correct this contradiction is only a force of language that will unite a heart separated into individuals. So what language should it be? It must be absolutely neutral. In addition, it must be concise and easy to learn. In music or a poem, it must enable a user free expression. Moreover, it as a language must have almost ideal completeness. So which language satisfies such conditions? Is it the English language? No. It is the international auxiliary language, the absolutely neutral language, i.e. the language Esperanto. Humanity, you all close your eyes calmly and recite one sentence of this international language. How does that present and peaceful melody sound to you? Taste the subsequent gentleness and tranquility of your heart. Precisely, this Esperanto language is God. It is God's language. Whoever can use this language will find God in it. And finally, I will introduce the grandest task of Naohi. Now his most important and great work was to initiate the construction of a main shrine in Ayabe. She published the project in 1984, when she was 82 years old. The shrine is located next to the hill. Omoto tried twice to build the main shrine around there, but due to the repressions of the Japanese government, the attempts failed. Onisaburo once said that if this Choseiden shrine was completed, God's plan would come true. So building the shrine was a heartfelt wish for all Omoto followers. And this prayer house had a deep fatality with Naohi. The first main shrine in Ayabe was completed in 1921, before the first incident of Omoto. On the occasion of the worship service to congratulate the completion, Naohi served as the highest priest. However, about 100 days later, it was broken due to the first incident. In the worship service to say goodbye to the shrine, Naohi again served as the highest priest. Before the second repression, the basic part for the main shrine was completed on the hill. But because of the second incident, everything was lost. Initially, it was said that 15 years and 10 billions of money were needed to build it. So, a really great job. The people of Omoto donated money, and so much money was raised. In addition, 8 years after its construction, it was completed on the occasion of the 100 years anniversary of the founding of Omoto. The time taken to build it was shortened, thanks to feelings of Omoto followers, such that during Naohi's life, they wanted to complete it. By the way, it goes without saying that under Naohi's initiative, Japanese traditional construction method was adapted for the building. But unfortunately, Naohi went to heaven on September 23, 1990, before seeing the completion of the shrine, when she was 88 years old. Hidemaru also ascended after more than 1 year of Naohi's ascension, when he was 93 years old. Their work is inherited to Kyoko, the fourth spiritual leader, and now to a fifth, Kurenai. A cherry tree konohana stands briskly next to the shrine and watches Omoto followers. Thank you very much.